Hello world, I'm Missy Girl, and welcome back to another video with your girl, Missy Girl. Excuse the wrinkled shirt, and excuse my hair, it looked better this morning. So, just push that aside, that's besides the point. I'm so sorry, let me change my lighting, hold on. That's better. I'm so sorry I haven't posted in a while. I've been busy with work, and quite frankly, I hadn't really had any ideas as to what to post on my YouTube channel. So, I just literally thought about this idea, like, 20 minutes ago. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna make a video about it. So hopefully everybody's doing well on this terrific Tuesday. I miss you guys so much. Hopefully your family's doing well. Stay safe, stay well, stay happy, stay blessed. So before we get into this video, make sure to like it up, subscribe, comment below what you want to see me do or talk about. And yeah, let's get into it. So we're gonna talk about the difference between friend zone and friendships before relationships. Okay, so I feel like this video is really important because I've experienced being friend zone and I've experienced friends before relationships and the importance of that. So we're gonna get into that and what that means and the difference between it, because there's definitely a difference between the two. So let's get started. Yeah, get a drink of water real quick because you know your girl be thirsty. All right, so as many of you guys know, I'm single, been single for quite a while. I had a relationship back last year, the end of August to the beginning of September. Literally, we broke up in a week. That's another, I think I told that story before. Anyway, that's besides the point. It wasn't that long. So I'd say my last relationship was literally like 4 years ago, honestly. So yeah, so the difference between being friend-zoned and having a friendship before a relationship. Let's talk about the friend zone, because y'all, I've been through it, I've experienced it, it's not fun. So when someone friend zones you, or when you friend zone a person, they're blatantly and plainly not interested in you at all. They just see you as a friend. They don't want anything to do with a relationship with you, or furthermore, they just want to be friends with you, and that's it. No matter how much you tell the person, or how much you tell, or how much the person tells you, no matter what, they just want to be friends with you. And they can literally say it as simple as, I'm not interested in you, I just see us as friends. Or they can say, I'm flattered that you like me, but I don't like you that way. I just see you as a friend, or as a sister, or as a best friend, or as a brother, or whatever. So I've been friend zoned a couple of times. My not really recent friend zone, but recent enough where I can basically tell this story. My guy best friend, right? Let's just call him Blue. Okay, that's a favorite color. Blue, right? So we were kind of cool in high school. He's 2 years younger than me. We didn't start becoming cool until I got into college at Montclair. And I honestly don't remember how I got his number. I guess he gave it to me on the bus one day because he stood up in my neighborhood. He lives in a different city now. So I basically started to develop feelings for him because we went on dates and we kissed and we did some other things that was a little bit more intimate. And I basically fell in love with him. And I told him this recently. Yes, it's been recently since I told him this. Mind you, I fell in love with him last year, but I just really didn't feel like I should tell him this because I didn't know how our friendship would lead, right? He basically told me that he only sees me as a friend in a sense. And he also said that he doesn't really want a relationship right now. He just wants to like live his life and things like that. I'm like, all right, cool. So it was like an on and off again relationship between the two of us in terms of like how I felt with him. I would feel these feelings with him and I could tell that it wouldn't really lead anywhere. So I kind of subsided my feeling, but feelings kind of subsided. And then they would build up again when we hung out more and we would kiss more and things like that. And he made it strictly clear that he just wanted me to be his best friend. And I was like, all right, no problem. So now my feelings have subsided completely. I haven't even seen him in a long time. I text him every day. He texts me every day as well. And honestly, I don't feel as though my feelings will progress to that level again because I know for a fact that he doesn't want anything to do with me in terms of a relationship. I don't know if it's because he's not ready for a relationship. And we talked about that multiple times before. I said, you know, if I'm still single, if you're still single, then, you know, maybe we can be something. And he was like, yeah, sure, like kind of like brushing it off or whatever. So that's basically the example of me being friend zoned, because he literally told me that he just sees me as a friend. And I wrote a poem about him and I shared it with him a couple of months ago and he really liked it. But I wrote the poem last year. I just sent it to him this year. And he was just like, oh, thanks, like, you're a great friend. And I'm just like, okay, well, that's literally a friend zone. When they're telling you that you're a great friend, despite your feelings towards them or despite their feelings towards you, if they're telling you or you're telling them that they're a great friend and that's it, then that's the friend zone. You will be hurt by it. They might be hurt by it, you know, on a vice versa level. If, you know, you're doing it to them or they're doing it to you, the person will be hurt, because at the end of the day, we are human and we are emotional people and we have the right to feel, especially females. We are very emotional people. So if the person, guy or female, friend zones you, yes, it's okay to cry. It's okay to be upset. It's okay to have these feelings, because at the end of the day, we're human, and vice versa. Don't get mad at the person for feeling the way they feel. If you friend zone that person, don't get mad at them for being upset. Don't get mad at them for taking a break from you for a while. That's just how they feel. They have feelings for you. You have, or vice versa, you have feelings for them. So it's quite all right to step away from that person for a couple of days. And it's up to you, or it's up to the person, again, vice versa, because it could work both ways, to determine if you still want to be friends with that person or not. I know there's a lot of people that like someone and they develop feelings for that person and they rejected them and they said we can only be friends, and they didn't want to be friends with them because they felt as though their feelings would still be there and being friends with them would, like, they won't be able to improve or they won't be able to find someone new because they still have the feelings for them. You know what I mean? So, yeah, friend zone is totally normal. I'm not saying that it's the best thing, because obviously someone does get hurt in a situation. It's perfectly normal to get hurt. It's perfectly normal to feel sad or upset or whatever it is that you're feeling. Like I said before, at the end of the day, we're human, so we have the right to feel that way. But it happens. You know, you can either be friends with that person again, or they can be friends with you again, or you can just go your separate ways and say, hey, listen, it's not going to work out. I still like you. I feel as though the best thing that we can do is just depart and go our separate ways, because I feel like if I'm still friends with you, I will develop these feelings again constantly. And with my situation, I had to think about it, and I'm like, no, I really don't want to lose him as a friend. He's a really great friend. You know, he's been there with me my ups and downs, and vice versa. I've been there with him through his ups and downs. I don't want to lose my friendship with him because he just wants to see me as a friend. I will just stop liking him, you know? So that is the friend zone feelings, thoughts, and story behind it. Now, the friendship story behind it before relationship, I feel as though it's very important to establish a friendship foundation before you get into a relationship. With that being said, all of the two relationships that I've been in, well, 2.5, counting the guy that I dated for a week or whatever, I didn't really have a friendship foundation with that person. It was more so we talked, we texted, we flirted, we talked about hanging out, we went out on a date, and then like the next day or whatever, we were in a relationship. And of course it didn't work, because here I am still single. So I feel like it's really important, if you like someone, if you really care about someone, you should start off with being friends with them, getting to know them, getting to know what makes them angry, happy, sad, hurt, depressed, getting to know their family, things like that. And I'm not saying that you can't be intimate with them, but try to limit that intimacy. You can hug, right? You can hold hands, right? You can hang out. But in terms of kissing, yeah, no, you guys are just friends. Now, if the feelings of friendships are improving and they're becoming more into it, interested, wanting to talk to you, wanting to date you type of thing, then yes, you can start with a slight kiss, a little peck on the lips. That's perfectly fine, because it shows that you are interested in the person, and vice versa, the person is interested in you. Now, there is no set timeline on how long you should be friends with that person before you move to the next step. It's honestly all up to the person. I've known people that have been friends with someone for 4 years, and then they date. They are exclusive, they're in a relationship, and then 2 years after they start to date, they get married, right? And it works better that way, because you've built a foundation with them. You built trust with them, as opposed to just jumping right into relationships. Like I said before, I had my fair share of doing that. I don't want to do that anymore. I'm growing up. I'm maturing. I'm realizing that being friends with a person first is the best way to go. So with my example, I had an example with the friend zone situation. So now I have an example with the friendship before relationship situation. I am very much interested in this guy, right? I'm going to call him Green, right? I don't know why. I just looked at this bridle on my nightstand. We're going to call him Green. So we were flirting at first, right? And he came up to me and he was like, yeah, like I just wanted to start off as friends first. I want to take things slow. I really do like you. I really do care for you. But I feel as though being friends, I mean, there's other things behind it. We're not going to get into all of that stuff because it's very personal and it's very a complicated situation. Yeah. So I'm just going to basically like sugarcoat and basically like cover up the gist of our conversation. Right. So he was like, yeah, like I really like you. I see you as going somewhere in the future, but we should start off as friends first. I'm like, yeah, most definitely. I feel like taking it slow is the best way to go. I've had my fair share of being in relationships and jumping into relationships and things like that, and it never worked, hence the reason why I'm still single. And he was like, yeah, exactly, like I really feel as though being starting off as friends is the best way to go. That's a very mature response, because somebody that's not interested in you or only wants you for certain things will literally just tell you that they're not interested in you, or tell you that they're only in it for certain things. But if they tell you that you want, that they want to be friends and start off slow, and you agree with them, then perfect. You guys can still hang out. You guys can still do things together. You guys can still talk and text and go on the phone, FaceTime, whatever it is that you do. And then you guys can work on being in a relationship. And again, it doesn't matter if it's a month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 2 years, 3 years. It all depends on that person. In my example, I literally just met this guy like a month ago, literally. So this is still kind of fresh. It's still kind of new to the both of us. And I can tell that he's interested in me. And obviously, I'm pretty sure he knows that I'm interested in him as well. So I'm not going to rush into anything. You know, I'm going to take things slow, get to know him, be friends with him. Yes, of course, still hang out. I'm not going to be as flirtatious as I was in the beginning. And I feel as though he's not going to be either, because that's going to ruin our friendship pattern, you know. But I really feel like it's important to get to know the person as friends first, because when you're in a relationship, of course, you're not going to know the person in its entire and their entirety, because people grow and change every day, every week, every month, every year. So that will never, ever, ever change. You will never know the person's true self. But at least with the friendship, you get to be on another understanding with them. And who knows, maybe if things don't work out, you can say to the person, well, listen, we've been friends before. Let's continue to be friends. And you can have a great friendship, right? For my example, like I said before, we just started to get to know each other about a month ago. So I'm not going to be like, oh my gosh, do you like me? Do you like me? Do you like me? I'm not even going to flirt with him as much as I really want to, because I really like him. I'm not going to do that, because I'm not going to jeopardize, number one, our friendship. And I'm not going to jeopardize, number two, what could possibly be. And what I mean what could possibly be is we could possibly be in a relationship, and me constantly putting my pressure, me putting myself onto him and pressuring him can make him step back and feel uncomfortable and not want to date me, and also not want to be my friend. And he's a really great friend. So I really cherish and value the friendship that we have. And I really do hope that we do end up being something in the future. And if not, that's perfectly fine, as long as I know that we can still be friends. What was I going to say about feelings? So yeah, you just have to kind of know yourself and know your feelings, and know that if you guys are friends, it's important to not really flirt with each other as much, because feelings will develop quickly, and when they develop quickly, it might rush the process, and that other person might not be ready to be in a relationship with you, because they just want to continue to be friends until you guys both have a mutual agreement on being in a relationship. You know what I mean? Let's say, for example, okay, we have yellow and we have me, right? Let's say, for example, I constantly flirt with him, and he's like, wait a minute, Naya, we're just friends, remember that? Like, yes, I'm interested in you, yes, I like you, but right now we're just friends. Can you please relax on the flirting and things like that, right? Then he might feel pressured, he might feel rushed, right? But when we get to the agreement where we've been friends for 6 months, 7 months, a year, I don't know how long it will take. It's only up to, you know, the two of us. It's only up to the two of you guys to decide that. Then we can sit down together and say, hey, listen, I feel as though we've known a lot about each other. I know what makes you happy. I know what makes you sad. I know what makes you angry. I know what makes you irritated. And I know you on your best days. I know you on your worst days. So what we gonna do, right? And if they say, then okay, yes, I'm ready to, if he says yes, I'm ready to move on to the next step with you, then you can continue with the flirting and the kissing and the hugging and all, well, him and I never kissed, but the flirting and the kissing and the level of intimacy that you plan on having, you know what I mean? So it's really important to distinguish between friend zone and friendship before relationships. So I hope that all makes sense. If you have any questions, any suggestions, any recommendations, any ideas, anything, please comment below. I love you all so much. Have a great week. I hope to see you all soon. Hopefully I will post more frequently. Pardon me. So yeah, that's all for the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share, comment, and yeah.